slide 16. Alright, so this one, I'm listing some common DLL files on the Windows. So kernel 32, that's the one of the mostly used DLL that deals with memory operation and then file operation. So you will see, you will hear kernel 32 among this through this class. And user 32 that DLL has like a Windows usually GUI related GUI component. You see like there's a status bar or scrolling bar buttons. You know those when an application uses those features, then it includes the user 32 that DLL. And you know why it's important? Because you know, let's say malware has included user 32 that DLL, that means it may have some GUI components in it. And GDI is more graphics, you know, related to fonts, you know, actual drawing type. And ntdll.dll, this DLL mostly usually is not used by application directly, but how it's being used, kernel32.dll has some functionality, then many times they actually use ntdll more in system level. Then ntdll.dll actually then call the kernel function calls, the system call. That's how it's related. So, and ws2_32.dll, when you see this DLL in the malware, that means it is using, opening the socket, you know, directly. And when inet.dll, it has more higher level. So rather than dealing with the socket directly, it just use like, okay, open HTTP, some, you know, the connection. Then you, in that case, then when inet.dll is being imported. Any question? And there are, you know, tons of more DLLs, but we, since we cannot go through every DLL in detail, but just we're gonna look, there are some important ones, as I mentioned. And in this one, as you see, kernel is actually kernel memory space is up, and the user space is in the bottom. Do you know why that's the case? This was a, you know, when you say, you know, hey, something is called, some function called, then you usually draw from the up to down, right? Calling it, and the system level is underneath. And but it was opposite case. Okay, it's because of the address, memory address.
Oh, okay.
Right. So if we just stack, usually I will explain this a little bit later, but you know, just based on the address. So this case, kernel for Windows case. I think for Linux is also we want to the same. So kernel usually if it's a 32-bit machine, for kernel memory address space start with a hex, like the office level is 1, which means 0. So kernel address space started from 80 and 600000. Right, that's the kernel memory space as a memory address wise. And for the user space level, it's below 800000. So it's, you know, from the 0 to, you know, before the 80000. So anyway, that's what it looks like. Yes, that's right, yes. So yeah, so the one that I mentioned was by default on the 32-bit, but you can configure it as how the machine needed. Yeah, so that's why it's just kernels up, but here, how this library is being used. Let's say you have the myapp.exe, and it is calling the right file that is actually belongs to kernel32.dll. Then, if this there's a function call, then it goes to here kernel32.dll. Then, in the inside, actually, you know, right file in the kernel32.dll. It is doing nothing but actually calling a function that belongs to ntdll.dll. Then from there, ntdll.dll actually calls some system call that located in the kernel.